Hi, this is Kevin at the Virtual Planetarium at Raritan Valley Community College. Welcome to our weekly Star Talk. Today we're going to be talking about the fall equinox, which is coming up shortly. But before we do that, let's talk about our upcoming moon phases. We have full moon on September 20th, we have a last quarter moon on September 28th, and then the next new moon is going to be on October 6th. Now, this upcoming full moon on September 20th has the name of the Harvest Moon. And this is the name we give to the full moon that's closest to the fall equinox. As we mentioned in our Colors of the Moon video, I'm going to put the link for that in the description, these names don't actually mean anything for the moon. They were simply made up and assigned to the different calendar months to help farmers keep track of what month it is and what moon it is and whatnot. Now, like I said, the Harvest Moon is the one that's closest to the fall equinox, and the fall equinox is going to be on September 22nd. And so this full moon is going to be 2 days before it, so obviously it's the closest one to it. Now, why does it have this name? Well, this full moon is called the Harvest Moon because it would give farmers a little bit of extra light. Back in the old days, before we had electricity or farmers had light, they would have to gather their crops during daylight. They would use the daylight to gather their crops. Well, during this time of the year, when a lot of them are harvesting their summer crops, the days are getting shorter and shorter, which means they have less daylight to be able to work, to be able to collect their crops. But when we have a full moon, it's actually really, really bright, and it would let them work a little bit later into the nighttime as well. So because this full moon would help farmers gather their crops, that's why it's called the Harvest Moon. Now, speaking of shorter days and the equinox, let's talk about what that means. As you've probably noticed, the days are getting shorter and shorter, which is very sad. The sun is already rising at like 6:45 in the morning, and it's setting at like 7 o'clock at night, which is really, really sad. The days have actually been getting shorter since the summer solstice on June 20th, and they're going to keep getting shorter until we get to the winter solstice on December 21st. Now the equinox, that date coming up on September 22nd, is the date right in between those two. And because it's right in between those days, it means that daytime and nighttime are actually the same length. As you probably noticed, the days in the summer are longer than nighttime. That's why summer is so much fun, because you get to play in the daytime a lot more. But by contrast, in the wintertime, the nighttime is longer than the daytime. The summer solstice is also known as the longest day of the year, while the winter solstice is known as the shortest day of the year. Now, the equinox is actually the day that lands right in between those two, which means that the daytime is actually just as long as the nighttime for that date. Now, if you know a little bit of Latin, you can split that word in two. You can split equinox in two and take the first part, equa, and that means equal, and then nox means night. So the word literally translates to equal night. So in a 24-hour day split in two, 12 hours are daylight, and then 12 hours are of nighttime. Now, why does this happen exactly? Well, it happens because the Earth is actually tilted by about 23 degrees. And because of this tilt, sometimes the sun is higher in the sky, like in the summertime, and sometimes it is lower in the sky, like in the wintertime. We actually talked a lot about this in our summer solstice video. I'm going to put the link for that video in the description as well, so you can see a view from outer space also if you would like, but we're going to talk about it a little bit more here. Now here we have two curves, two paths that the sun takes. The one on the top represents summertime. As you can see up there, it says June 21st, and that is the date of the summer solstice, and that is again the longest day of the year. And that is when the sun is highest up in the sky, so it spends more time in the sky. Now the curve we have at the bottom down there represents the winter solstice, or the shortest day of the year, and that's when the sun is lowest in the sky, it's closest to the horizon. Now, the fall equinox actually lies right in between these dates, so because the sun is happily in between these two points, is that we have the same amount of daytime as we have the same amount of nighttime, which is pretty cool. Thank you so much for joining us today. Hope you learned something new. Again, I'm going to put those videos in the description. You can check them out later if you want, if you haven't watched them already. If you like this video, be sure to give us a like, and if you haven't yet, please subscribe to our channel. We're going to be putting out a new video every week. Once again, thank you for joining us, and hope you have a great week.